Welcome to our in-depth guide on ISO 14971, the international standard for risk management in the medical device industry. In this video, we'll break down the key concepts, requirements, and practical steps to implement a robust risk management process for medical devices. Introduction to ISO 14971. ISO 14971 is the globally recognized standard for managing risks associated with medical devices. It provides a comprehensive framework for identifying hazards, assessing risks, and implementing controls throughout the product lifecycle, from design to post-market surveillance. Whether you're developing an implantable device or a software-based diagnostic tool, ISO 14971 helps ensure patient safety and regulatory compliance. The importance of risk management in medical devices. Risk management is more than just a regulatory requirement. It is a continuous process critical to ensuring the safety and performance of your medical devices. Implementing a risk management process early in the product design phase allows you to identify and mitigate potential hazards, thereby reducing the likelihood of recalls, adverse events, or patient harm. The risk management process, step by step. ISO 14971 outlines a structured process for managing risk, starting with the risk management plan. This document specifies all the risk management activities needed throughout the device's lifecycle, including roles and responsibilities, timelines, and risk acceptability criteria. Let's explore the key stages of this process. Risk analysis. Identify potential hazards associated with your device, estimate the risks, and document them in a risk management file. Risk evaluation. Compare the estimated risks against your predefined acceptability criteria to determine whether they are acceptable or need further control. Risk control. Implement measures to reduce the risk to acceptable levels and verify that these measures are effective. Documentation of residual risks is crucial here. Post-market surveillance. Risk management doesn't end at product launch. You must continuously monitor the device's performance. Collect post-production data and revise your risk management file as needed to ensure ongoing safety and compliance. Developing a risk management plan. Your risk management plan is a living document and a central element of ISO 14971 compliance. It identifies the risk management activities that occur at every stage of your device's lifecycle. It's important to define who is responsible for each task and to ensure regular updates as the product progresses through design, production, and post-market stages. Clear documentation and accountability are critical for successful implementation. Key concepts: hazard, risk, and harm. ISO 14971:2019 introduces key definitions that form the foundation of risk management. These are hazard, risk, and harm. Hazard. A hazard is defined as a potential source of harm. ISO 14971:2019, Clause 3.18. Hazards can arise from the design, external factors, or even how the device is used. For instance, in a pacemaker, a hazard could be a failure in its electrical circuit that may prevent it from functioning correctly. Risk. Risk is the combination of the probability of occurrence of harm and the severity of that harm. ISO 14971:2019, Clause 3.19. For example, the risk of a pacemaker malfunction combines the likelihood of failure and the severity of the impact, which could range from minor inconvenience to serious injury or death. Harm. Harm refers to any injury or damage to people, property, or the environment. ISO 14971:2019, Clause 3.16. In the context of medical devices, harm typically refers to injury to a patient or user. For instance, harm caused by a malfunctioning pacemaker could result in life-threatening conditions. Defining risk acceptability criteria. One critical aspect of ISO 14971 is defining your risk acceptability criteria. This involves determining the acceptable levels of risk before risk controls are implemented. Typically, you will define the severity of potential harm, the probability of occurrence, and how easily the risk can be detected. These factors are often organized into a risk matrix to help you assess whether the risk is acceptable or requires further controls. It's crucial to establish these thresholds early to avoid bias during risk evaluation. Managing residual risk and risk-benefit analysis. Once controls have been implemented, it's essential to assess residual risk. This is the remaining risk after mitigation measures. If the residual risk is still unacceptable, further actions must be taken. In some cases, a risk-benefit analysis is required, particularly for life-saving devices, where a certain level of risk may be justified by the benefits. This analysis must be thoroughly documented to demonstrate that the benefits of using the device outweigh any potential harm. Examples of risk controls in action. Risk controls can vary widely depending on the type of medical device. For example, an implantable device manufacturer may implement strict infection control measures during production, such as using sterilized materials and performing rigorous biocompatibility testing. These controls help mitigate the risk of post-surgical infections, which could otherwise lead to serious patient harm. Documenting the effectiveness of these controls is essential for ISO 14971 compliance. Linking ISO 14971 to regulatory compliance. ISO 14971 isn't just about internal risk management. It also aligns with external regulatory requirements. The standard helps medical device manufacturers meet the requirements of the FDA's Quality System Regulation, QSR, and the EU Medical Device Regulation, MDR. By integrating risk management into your quality system, you can streamline the regulatory submission process and prepare for audits more effectively. ISO 14971 compliance is often seen as a strong foundation for demonstrating the safety and effectiveness of medical devices in regulatory submissions. Continuous improvement through post-market surveillance. The post-market surveillance phase is an integral part of the risk management process. By collecting real-world data on your device's performance, you can continuously update your risk management file and make improvements. This feedback loop between post-market surveillance and risk management ensures that any emerging risks are promptly addressed and device safety is continuously improved. ISO 14971 is a crucial standard that ensures the safety and effectiveness of your medical devices. By following a structured risk management process, you can protect patients and ensure regulatory compliance. Implementing effective risk controls and continuously updating your risk management file will help your organization succeed in this ever-evolving regulatory landscape. Stay tuned for more in-depth videos from eLeaP on risk management and ISO standards. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more expert content.